Good afternoon, everyone. So today, Anika and her team, they are presenting on youth health, lifestyle, AIDS, and first aid for all the health problems or diseases. So this is with respect to, again, youth only. So last week, it was about the role of youth in nation building. It was very good presentation. So similarly, today also, Anika and her team is presenting on this topic. I welcome you all. Group 4, this is?
Ma'am, 3, ma'am.
Okay, we can start, Anika.
Ma'am, is the screen visible?
Screen is visible. Your voice is audible.
Yes, ma'am. A very good afternoon to one and all present here. My name is Anika Prakash, and today I would like to welcome you all to the presentation of our group. The topic that we have chosen for today's presentation is youth health, lifestyle, AIDS, and first aid. Before we get into the presentation, I would like to introduce you to all my group members. Group members are Adarsh, Adarsh Mutnal, Aishwarya, Aishwarya S, Akshata J, myself Anika Prakash, Amrita CS, Anusha LS, Bhavani U, Akul Gowda, Arjun GL, Biresh M, Bhargav Reddy, Arun Kumar H, Bhaskar Gowda TN, MV Bahul Reddy, Amul. Before we get into our main topic, I would like to talk about something in general, that is, what exactly does health mean? According to the WHO, health is defined as a state where you are in complete, total, physical, mental, and social well-being. In simple common words terms, we can say that a person is said to be healthy if there is absence of any disease. I wouldn't find a better situation to explain the importance of health than the situation we are in today. The COVID-19 pandemic has made all of us understand how important health and lifestyle can be. The health status of a particular country is often measured in terms of its death rate. So this small pie chart here indicates the comparison of 1990 to 2016 as to what are the major contributions that have led to death in our country. We can see a spiking rise in the contribution of non-communicable diseases, which is very alarming for us. Non-communicable diseases indicate the absence of awareness about health and lifestyle. So that is what our presentation today would like to aim at, to make sure that we're more aware about our health and how we can look after our health. The next person will talk about youth health.
Good initiation by you, Anika.
Thank you.
Screen is not visible.
Is it visible now?
Yes, ma'am.
You can continue.
Hello, myself Adarsh Mudnar. My slide is about youth health and what makes youth health so special. I will first say about youth health. Youth health, adolescent health or youth health is the range of approaches to preventing, detecting or treating young people's health and well-being. The term adolescent and young people are often used interchangeably, as are the terms adolescent health and youth health. Young people health is often complex and requires a comprehensive approaches. Young people often lack awareness of the harm associated with risk behavior and the skill to protect themselves, as well as the lack knowledge about how and where to seek help for the health concern. By interviewing this early life stage, many chronic conditions later in the life can be prevented. Nika, change the slide. What makes youth health so special? Adolescent means both a period and a process during which a child becomes mature in terms of his or her mental, physical, and social opinions and beliefs. It is the period between 12 to 19 of age, and it can be considered as the bridge between childhood and adulthood. In this phase of immense physical and mental change, it is very important for one to watch their eating habits, physical activity, and mental development. It is a unique stage of human development and important time for laying foundation of good health. Adolescent experience rapid physical, cognitive, and psychosocial growth. They affect how they feel, think, make decision, and interact with the world around them. Thank you. Over to Aishwarya.
Okay, good continuation. Have you collected the statistics? With respect to youth suffering from various diseases?
Yes, ma'am, it's there.
Okay. Okay, you can continue. Anika, you can admit some students are waiting.
Okay, ma'am, I will admit.
I am not able to. I have made you as co-host, no? You have to admit.
Good afternoon, everyone. I am Aishwarya, and I am going to speak about major health problems in youth. Adolescence and young adulthood are generally considered healthy times of life. Several important public health and social behaviors and problems either start or peak during these years. Environmental factors, including family, peer group, school, neighborhood, policies, and societal cues, can both support or challenge youth health and well-being. Available evidence indicates that young people are prone to a number of health-impacting conditions due to personal choices, environmental influences, and lifestyle changes, including both communicable and non-communicable disorders. Others include substance use disorders like tobacco, alcohol, and others. Then suicides, sexually transmitted diseases, including HIV, teen and unplanned pregnancies, homelessness, violence, and several others. In all countries, whether developing or developed, disabilities and acute and chronic illness are often induced by economic hardship, unemployment, restrictions, poverty, or poorly distributed wealth at both individual and country level. Data from Nutrition Survey of National Institute of Nutrition during 2001 and 2006 showed that more than half of the population aged 10 to 18 years was undernourished. Studies from India is facing the dual burden of undernutrition and overnutrition, as also seen from other reports. There is also a challenge of nutritional transition, as Indians are moving away from traditional diets rich in cereal and fiber to more Western pattern diets that are rich in sugars, fat, and animal source food like fast food that are closely associated with different non-communicable diseases. Then at least 20% of young people are likely to experience some form of mental illness such as depression, mood disturbances, substance abuse, suicidal behaviors, eating disorders, and others. A six-year follow-up study in Chandigarh showed the incidence rate of psychiatric disorder to be 0.18% per year among the 10 to 17-year-old adolescents. Among the few specific common mental disorders, the prevalence of depression has varied from 0.1 to 18.5%, and anxiety from 0.1 to 24.4%. across different studies. Two studies showed prevalence of severe and extreme grade of depression in 11.2% of the school dropouts and 3% among the school-going adolescents aged 13 to 19 years and 18.4% among the 9th standard students. Promoting mental health and responding to problems on a continuous basis requires a range of adolescent-friendly healthcare and counseling services in communities. Then, depression anxiety stress scale, that is DASS, observed that 20% young adults experienced stress. It was found that among adolescent girls studying in 12th standard from Hisar and Hyderabad, 47.5 and 72.5% were in the moderate category of family stress. Financial stress was reported by 60 and 50%, and 90 and 85% had moderate level of social stress. In a study among adolescents aged 16 to 19 years, it was found that 90.6% adolescents had academic stress. Then coming to suicide. According to World Health Organization, estimates about 1 million people commit suicide each year. In India, nearly 136,000 persons voluntarily ended their lives in a suicidal act as per official reports in 2011. The official report indicates that age-specific suicide rate among 15 to 29 year is on the rise, increasing from 3.73 to 3.96 per 1 lakh population per year from 2002 to 2011. About 40% of suicides in India are committed by persons below the age of 30 year. Suicidal ideas and attempts were also found to be high in Chandigarh and South Delhi, with nearly 6% of individuals aged 11 to 17 year and 15% adolescents aged 14 to 19 year reporting suicidal ideas, while 0.4% students aged 11 to 17 year and 5.1% students aged 14 to 19 year reported suicidal attempts. Then about tobacco use. The vast majority of tobacco users worldwide begin the use of tobacco during adolescence. Currently, more than 150 million adolescents use tobacco, and this number is increasing globally. NFHS, that is National Family Health Survey, revealed that 40% of males and 5% of females aged 15 to 24 year consumed tobacco nationwide. Global Youth Tobacco Survey, that is GYTS, 2006 and 2009 across India, covering 13 to 15 year old adolescents in 180 schools, highlighted an increase in the current users of any form of tobacco from 13.7 to 14.6% and current users of cigarette from 3.8 to 4.4% from 2006 to 2009. The study in Noida City found that 8.8% of adolescents aged 11 to 19 year were ever smokers, 4.6% were ever tobacco chewers, 3.7% were exclusive smokers, and 2.5% were exclusive tobacco chewers. Data from several studies clearly point to the fact that tobacco addiction is emerging as a big threat among young Indians. Then about alcohol use. Harmful drinking among young people is an increasing concern in many countries and is linked to nearly 60 health conditions. It increases risky behaviors and is linked to injuries and violence, resulting in premature deaths. A national review on harmful effects of alcohol reported greater social acceptability of drinking, increasing consumption in rural and transitional areas, younger age of initiating drinking, and phenomenal socio-economic and health impact, more so among young people. Data from the National Household Survey, that is NHS, by United Nations Office on Drugs and Crime, 2002, covering urban and rural areas of 24 states of India, revealed a prevalence of 21.4% of alcohol use among men aged 12 to 18 years. The NFHS survey showed that 1% women and 11% men aged 15 to 19 years consumed alcohol. The present review, though limited in nature, highlights that a significant proportion of youth has health-impacting behaviors and conditions that affect their growth and development, that the problem is on increase and likely to increase in the coming years. Many of these problems are closely linked to ongoing nutrition. There is a strong need for public health community to identify, prepare, integrate, and implement activities that help to promote health and healthy lifestyles of young people. Strategic investment in health, nutrition, education, employment, and welfare are critical for healthy growth of young people, and these programs need to be monitored and evaluated for their efficacy and effectiveness using public health approaches. Next slide.
All students are listening now. Very good data she is giving. This is very, very important slide that affects your personality development, that affects your behavior, and that affects your even success also in future. This is very important topic. Okay, ma, continue.
Then about mental health. Mental health, defined by the World Health Organization, is a state of well-being in which the individual realizes his or her own abilities, can cope with the normal stresses of life, can work productively and fruitfully, and is able to make a contribution to his or her community. From the perspectives of positive psychology, mental health may include an individual's ability to enjoy life and to create a balance between life activities and efforts to achieve psychological resilience. Mental health problems may arise due to stress, loneliness, depression, anxiety, relationship problems, death of a loved one, suicidal thoughts, grief, addiction, self-harm, and various mood disorders, as well as learning disabilities. Therapists, psychiatrists, psychologists, social workers, nurse practitioners, or family physicians can help manage mental illness with treatments such as therapy or medication. It is very important to improve our emotional mental health by surrounding yourself with positive relationships. We as humans feed off companionships and interactions with other people. Another way to improve your emotional mental health is by participating in activities that can allow you to relax and take time for yourself. Yoga is a great example of an activity that calms your entire body and nerves. Prevention of a disorder at a young age may significantly decrease the chances that a child will suffer from a disorder later in life. Prevention may require the regular consultation of a physician for at least twice a year to detect any signs that reveal any mental health concerns. Similar to mandated health screenings, bills across the US are being introduced to require mental health screenings for students attending public schools. Supporters of these bills hope to diagnose mental illness such as anxiety and depression to prevent self-harm and any harm induced on other students. Additionally, social media is becoming a resource for prevention. In 2004, the Mental Health Services Act began to fund marketing initiatives to educate the public on mental health. While social media can benefit mental health, it can also lead to deterioration if not managed properly. Then how can we improve mental health? One is physical activity. For some people, physical exercise can improve mental as well as physical health. Playing sports, walking, cycling, or doing any form of physical activity triggers the production of various hormones which can elevate a person's mood. Studies have shown that in some cases, physical activity can have the same impact as antidepressants when treating depression and anxiety. Then second is activity therapies. Activity therapy is also called recreation therapy and occupational therapy promote healing through active engagement. An example of occupational therapy would be promoting an activity that improves daily life, such as self-care or improving hobbies. Similarly, recreational therapy focuses on movement, such as walking, yoga, or riding a bike. Each of these therapies have proven to improve mental health and have resulted in healthier, happier individuals. In recent years, for example, coloring has been recognized as an activity that has been proven to significantly lower the levels of depressive symptoms and anxiety in many studies. Then third is expressive therapies. Expressive therapies or creative art therapies are a form of psychotherapy that involves the art or art making. These therapies include art therapy, music therapy, drama therapy, dance therapy, and poetry therapy. It has been proven that music therapy is an effective way of helping people who suffer from a mental health disorder. Then fourth is meditation. The practice of meditation has several mental health benefits, such as bringing about reduction in depression, anxiety, and stress. Meditation may also be effective in treating substance use disorders. Further, mindfulness meditation appears to bring about favorable structural changes in the brain. Then fifth is mental fitness. Mental fitness is a mental health movement that encourages people to intentionally regulate and maintain their emotional well-being through friendship, regular human contact, and activities that include meditation, calming exercises, aerobic exercise, mindfulness, having a routine, and maintaining adequate sleep. Next slide. Here are some ways to how can you look after your mental health. This keep physically active. Second, eat well. Get a good night's sleep. Connect with others. Do something you are good at. Then ask for help. Develop coping strategies and talk with everyone. From here, my friend will continue.
Very good presentation by you. It's very valuable message for you.
Thank you, ma'am.
I can continue.
Good afternoon, everyone. Myself, Bhargav, I'm going to share you a topic about importance of youth health. Youth health is important because it is a wide range of influence. It can be influenced by experiencing during the adolescence. For some, it is compromised. There is significant room of improvement. Adolescence is not just a question of individual well-being, but a major determination of social, economic development and process as well. Country population majorly consists of youth. Nowadays, youth are getting very distracted because of they are getting into social medias, getting into different bad habits and all. So youth have to be having their control in their limits because it is the stepping stone of their life. And Anika, can you change the slide? Denga. 8 Anika. Ways to remain healthy and fit.
Okay.
8 ways to remain healthy and fit. Don't touch. Means whenever you go to any place where it's dirty area, we should not touch because nowadays viruses are getting very powerful and even our hygiene should be clean. Washing hands means hygiene. Our hygiene should be very important because after when we go outside and when we come to our homes, we should clean our hands and legs properly because infection are getting through hands and legs. Stop stressing. People are getting stressed nowadays because of many problems and all. So there are many techniques to control your stress, like yoga, meditation and all. Eat well. A person should have proper food for their life, because it's important for their health and their well-being, for getting the nutrition and all. Get fit. Because getting fit is a part of our life, because if we be well or fit, we never get any problems or any diseases, as well as no virus can attack us. Fundamental fluids. Our body should get proper amount of fluids, as well as because of our body should not dehydrate. Body should not dehydrate, as well as we should get proper nutrition and all. Sound sleep. We should have a sound sleep of 8 hours, because a person without proper sleep cannot have a proper health. And stay active, be healthy. Thank you.
Good message you have conveyed. How to manage? Very good.
Thank you, ma'am.
Good afternoon. Myself, Bhaskar Gowda. Here I am to speak about the healthy lifestyle. Ask 50 people to define what is a healthy lifestyle.
Can you switch on your video, if possible? Okay.
Ask 50 people to define what is a healthy lifestyle, and you will likely get the 50 different answers. That's because there is no one way to be healthy. A healthy lifestyle means simply doing the good things that make you happy and feel good. How it is beneficial? Making the changes to improve your health can lead to the benefits for your body, your mind, your wallet, and also even environment. It prevents diseases, saves money, lengthens the lifespan, and it can be good for the environment. Next slide. Keys to healthy lifestyle. The first point is healthy eating, nutrition, and diet. All humans have to eat the food for
growth. There is some problem with your video, I think. You can just mute your video. Yeah, you can continue.
Okay, ma'am. Healthy eating, nutrition, and diet. All humans have to eat food for growth and the maintenance of a healthy body. But we humans have the different nutrition requirement as infants, children, teenagers, youth, adult, and seniors. For example, infant may require feeding every 4 hours until they gradually age and begin to take in more solid food. Eventually, they develop into the more normal pattern of eating 3 times per day as young kids. However, as most parents know, kids, teenagers, and young adults often snack between the meals. Snacking is often not limited to these age groups, because adult and seniors often do the same. Tips. Eat 3 healthy meals a day: breakfast, lunch, and dinner. It is important to remember that dinner does not have to be the largest meal. Bulk of food consumption should consist of healthy food such as fruits, vegetables, whole grains, and fat-free or low-fat milk products. Incorporate lean meats, poultry, fish, beans, egg, and nuts into the healthy diet. Choose foods that are low in saturated fat, trans fat, cholesterol, salt, and added sugars. Look at the labels, because the first listed items on the label comprises the highest concentration of ingredients. Control the portion sizes. Eat the smallest portion that can satisfy hunger, and then stop eating. Eating snacks are okay in moderation and should consist of items like fruits, whole grains, or nuts to satisfy hunger and not cause excessive weight gain. Avoid soda and sugar-enhanced drinks because of excessive calories in the soda and the sugar drinks. Diet drinks may not be a good choice, as they make some people hunger and increase food consumption. Avoid eating the large meal before sleeping to decrease the gastroesophageal reflex and weight gain. If a person is angry or depressed, Eating will not solve these situations and make the underlying problem worse. After rewarding children with sugary snacks such as Patron may become a lifelong habit for people. Avoid heavy meals in the summer month, especially during the hot days. A vegetarian lifestyle has been prompted for a healthy lifestyle and weight loss. Vegetarians should check with their physicians to be sure they are getting enough vitamins, minerals, and iron in their diet. Cooking food destroys the most harmful bacteria and other pathogens. If you choose to eat uncooked food like fruits or vegetables, they should be thoroughly washed with running treated tap water light before eating. Avoid eating raw or undercooked meat of any type. Tips for special situations. People with diabetes should use above tips and monitor their glucose level as directed. Try to keep the daily blood glucose level as close to normal as possible. People with unusual work experiences, night shift, college students, military should try to adhere to a breakfast, lunch, and dinner routine with minimum snacks. People who prepare food should avoid using the grease or frying food in grease. People trying to lose weight should avoid all fatty and sugar food and eat mainly vegetables, fruits, nuts, and reduce the intake of meat and the dairy products. Seek medical advice early if you cannot control your weight, food intake, or if you have the diabetics and cannot control your blood glucose level. Thank you. I request Bahul to continue with the talk.
So, good afternoon, everyone. I will talk about the physical activity and exercise. The physical activity and exercise is a major contributor to a healthy lifestyle. People are made to use their bodies and disuse to unhealthy living. Unhealthy living may manifest itself in obesity, weakness, lack of endurance, and overall poor health that may foster disease developments. The tips for a physical activity is regular exercise, which can prevent and reverse age-related decreases in muscle mass and strength, improve balance, flexibility, and endurance. It decreases the risk of fall in elderly. Regular exercise can also prevent the coronary heart disease, stroke, diabetes, obesity, and high blood pressure. Regular fitness can help chronic arthritis sufferers to improve their capacity to perform daily activities such as driving, climbing stairs, and opening jars. Regular exercise can help increase self-esteem and self-confidence, decrease stress and anxiety, enhance mood, and improve general mental health. Regular exercise can help control body weight and in some people cause loss of fat. 30 minutes of modest exercise at least 3 to 5 days a week is recommended, but the greater health benefits come from exercising most days of the week. Exercise can be broken up into 10 small minute sessions. Start slowly and progress gradually to avoid injury or excessive soreness or fatigue. People are never too old to start exercise. Even frail elderly individuals can improve their strength and balance with exercise. Almost any type of exercise like resistant water aerobics, walking, swimming, weights, yoga, and many others are helpful for everybody. Children need exercise. Playing outside the home is a good beginning for the children. Sports for the children may provide excellent opportunities for exercise, but care must be taken not to do over certain exercise. The exertion during strenuous exercise may make a person tired and sore. But if the pain occurs, stop the exercise until the pain. The most individuals can begin moderate exercise such as walking without a medical examination. Now I will talk about the mental health. Healthy living involves more than physical health. It also includes emotional or mental health. The following ways are the people can support their mental health and well-being. Getting enough sleep daily. According to CDC, the CDC recommends the following age groups, that is 12 to 18 hours for a birth, for a child, for a baby, whereas the 7 to 9 hours for above adult and elderly people, and taking a walk and trying to do something new, doing some mind exercise, trying to focus a process intensely and completing its segment of it, and planning to spend some time talking with people around different subjects and having fun, letting yourself to be pleased with achievements and both big and small. The avoidance behavior is the another key to wellness, and this topic will be led by Akul Gowda. Thank you.
Okay, you have given very good timetable for youth for healthy living. Very good. So all of you should follow this timetable so that you will be physically fit, mentally fit, and you will be having a very good quality of life. Now, quality of life is the index that is measured along with your health. Okay. So as per WHO, that is World Health Organization, health is defined as physical, mental, and social well-being. No. So now you have to add one more aspect for that. That is quality of life. With good quality of life, no, your health is a complete state of physical, mental, and social well-being. Okay, this you keep in mind. So whatever he has presented, it's very good message he has given to all to follow for your healthy living. Okay, okay, it can be continued.
Slide.
Unnecessary sounds during the class.
Anika slides in. Dala. Hello, myself. I am Akul Gowda. My topic is to avoid the tobacco use, avoid the excessive alcohol consumption, avoid high-risk sexual behavior. First, I will continue with avoid the tobacco use. Tobacco use is the most important preventable illness and causes of death in US. According to the National Cancer Institute, tobacco use was estimated to be causes of 4,43,000 deaths in 2010. Tips: smoking, stop the smoking tobacco. Start to stop today. It takes about 15 years of non-smoking beer to achieve a normal.
Akul Gowda, Akul Gowda. That sound is from your mic only, I think. One pet is disturbing you. Can you make yourself convenient?
Okay, ma'am.
Because here, so many students are listening to your voice. It is recorded.
Okay. No, ma'am.
Now it is clear. Okay. Now it is clear. So during like this class hours, no, you should take care of your pets also.
Okay, ma'am.
Okay, you can continue.
Sorry for disturbance. Stop using chewing tobacco to avoid the oral cancer. Consequences of tobacco use. Tobacco use causes a large number of cancer. In men, 90% of lung cancer deaths and attribute of smoking. 80% in women. Tobacco use causes a cancer in the lungs, mouth, lip, tongue,
you can
kidney,
call
and bladder.
Women, okay? Women itself is plural. W-O-M-A-N is singular. W-O-M-E-N is plural, okay? Don't make it plural again. You pronounce it as women.
Okay, ma'am.
Okay, good.
It also further increases the risk of bladder cancer. And subjects occupationally exposed to the certain organic chemicals found in the textiles, leather, rubber, dye, paint, and other organic chemical industries, and further increases the risk of lung cancer. And pregnant women who smoke are more likely to deliver babies with a low baby weight. Tobacco use causes an attack, strokes, and lack of blood flow to the lower extremities. Tobacco use causes an estimate 20 to 30% of coronary heart disease in the US. It also further increases the risk of heart attacks among subjects like elevated cholesterol, uncontrolled hypertension. And I'll continue with avoid this alcoholic consumption. Consequences of alcoholic consumption. Excess alcoholic consumption is major cause of liver cirrhosis in US. Liver cirrhosis can cause a fluid accumulation in the abdomen, easy bleeding and muscles wasting, mental confusion, infection, and in advanced cases, coma and kidney failure. Liver cirrhosis can lead to a liver cancer. Alcohol content account of 40% to 50% of death from automobile accident. Alcohol users is a significant causes of injury and death from home accidents. And avoid high risk sex behavior. High sex sexual behavior can lead to a sexual transmitted illness such as gonorrhea and HIV infections. High risk sexual behavior is also known as to spread human papilloma virus infection, which can lead to a cervical cancer in women and other anogenital cancer in both men and women. High sex sexual behavior include the following: multiple sex partner with a history of following. Intravenous drug use and STDs. Consequences of high sex sexual behavior: transmission of HIV and other sexual transmitted disease, transmission of hepatitis B, 50% of hepatitis B infection are due to a sexual transmission, and in rare in cases hepatitis C also. Transmission of human papilloma virus HIV, which causes say, genital warts and anogenital. Most commonly cancer of the uterine cervix. Unplanned pregnancy. Tips: avoid the unprotected sex. If you are planning to sex and are unsure of your parents' health status, use a condom. Thank you. Next, my friend will be continuing.
Tobacco causes 1/3 of the total cancers in our country. So this also is one more additional information along with this. Chewing tobacco, it causes all oral cancers like mouth cancer, tongue cancer, throat cancer. It is mainly because of chewing tobacco. And it is one of the leading cause of 1/3 of the total cancers in our country. Okay, now our country is also has become one of the cancer capital also. Along with diabetes mellitus, that is non-communicable. Even cancer is non-communicable. So more cases are there. So what you are giving is good awareness that you should not inculcate such habits in your routine life, because it is going to unnecessarily damage your organs. Okay, like it will damage your mouth, tongue, you will lose taste. And what happens is your throat will also be affected and cheeks will be affected. Okay. And if chewing tobacco, if it is causing damage on cheek, what happens? Again, the other part of the skin will be taken, maybe on thighs and all, and it will be grafted on the cheek. So that mark also you can see on cancer patients. That is mainly because of chewing tobacco. So why to invite all such unnecessary problems, no? Which are with your control only, is it or not? So that's why you should have control on all these bad habits like chewing tobacco or taking alcohol or even other health related problems, also high risk sex behaviors and all, no, all these everything is in your control. Even cigarette smoking is also, it is also under your control only. If you avoid all this, so you can have a very good healthy personality. Okay, you can continue.
Hi friends, I am Arun and I'm teaching health education. Health education is a profession of educating people about health areas within this profession. Encompass environmental health, physical health, social health, emotional health, intellectual health, and spiritual health, as well as sexual and reproductive health education. The World Health Organization defined health education as comprising of consciously constructed opportunities for learning involving some form of communication designed to improve health literacy, including improving knowledge and developing life skills which are conducive to individual and community health. Changes like this. And it is also, it is a social science that draws from the biological, environmental, psychological, physical, and medical sciences to promote health and prevent diseases, disability, and premature and death through educating, driven, voluntary behavior change activities. Health education can be defined as the principle by which individual and groups of people learn to behave manner conducive to the promotion, maintenance, or restoration of health. However, as there are multiple definitions of health, there are also multiple definitions of health education. In America, the Joint Committee on Health Education and Promotion Technology of 2001 defined health education as any combination of planned learning experiences based on sound theories that provide individuals, groups, and communities the opportunity to acquire information and the skills needed to make a quality health education. And my friend Amul is going to explain the importance of health education. Thank you.
What happened? Gavi Siddesh, what happened?
Amul.
Ma'am. Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. Hello? Ma'am, I can.
Audible, Amul.
Okay. Hello, good afternoon, everyone. I am Amul. I explain two objectives of health education. First of all, I say to health education, the education which promote an understanding of how to maintain personal health. The health education objectives are, there are four main objectives as per the WHO. First one is to make an individual learn the habits and practices that promote health and follow them throughout his life faithfully. Means, what we learning about health education, it is a continuous process, not giving, and it is faithful throughout our life. And second one is to enable everyone to make use of all available community facilities and resources to preserve and improve health. And the third one, an individual or community from doing anything that may be injurious to health of any other individual or community. And fourth, adoption of healthy lifestyle. Change the slide. And next, importance of healthy education. There are some importance of health education. First one is it improves health status of individuals, families, communities, states, and the nation. And second, enhance quality of life for all. It enhances the quality of students and elders, youngers. No age limit. It enhances quality of life for all person peoples. And third one, build students' knowledge, skills, and attitude about health. It is very essential for students. It helpful for students. And students learn skills they will use to make healthy choice throughout their lifetime. And it motivates students to improve and maintain their health, prevent disease, and reduce risky behavior. It's over.
Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Adarsh. I am here to tell about AIDS. The word AIDS stands for Acquired Immunodeficiency Syndrome. This means deficiency of the immune system acquired during the lifetime of an individual, indicating that it is not a congenital disease. Syndrome means a group of the symptoms. AIDS was first reported in the 1981. In India, AIDS was first reported in 1986, diagnosed by Dr. Shriniti Salmon and her student Dr. Sellappan Nirmala among the 6 female sex workers in the Chennai. And in the last 25 years or so, it has happened, spread all over the world, killing more than 25 million people. So AIDS has no permanent cure has been formulated for this disease. It is very important we focus on prevention. In the society, there are a lot of misconceptions with respect to this disease. As youth, it is important that we are all aware of the truths and myths of this disease. Next slide. Let's see how this AIDS spreads. The common fluids that are means of transmissions are blood, semen, vaginal secretion, breast milk, and amniotic fluids. And sexual contact with the infected person and by transfusion of contaminated blood and blood products by sharing infected needles, as in case of the intravenous drug abusers, and from infected mother to her child through placenta. So people who are at high risk of getting this infection include individuals who have multiple sex partners, drug addicts who take drug intravenously. Even though saliva also carries HIV particles, it has only 1% per ml of fluid. Therefore, we can say that saliva doesn't come under one of the common modules of the transmission. And there are some of the misconceptions are also there. Means how the AIDS will not come. Previous slide. Means the HIV, how the AIDS is not transmitted. That is through by touching or through food with the kiss and insect bites and in the pool. Next. Stages and symptoms of the HIV. Mainly there are 4 stages. There are asymptomatic stage, mild symptomatic, advanced symptoms, and the severe symptom of the AIDS. In the asymptomatic stage, it is short, flu-like illness occur 1 to 6 weeks after the infection. Infection person can infect other people. The second one is mild symptoms, average 10 years. Mild symptoms, HIV in blood drops to very low levels. Antibodies are detected in the blood. In the third stage, that is advanced symptoms, the immune system deteriorates. Opportunistic infections starts or appear. The fourth stage is severe symptoms. That is rapid decline in the number of the CD4 plus cells. Opportunistic infections become severe and cancer may develop. Let's see how that this AIDS will come. The first AIDS is a RNA. viral RNA core will first infect the human cell. The viral RNA is introduced into the cell, and that viral DNA is produced by the reverse transcriptase. Viral DNA incorporate into host genome. New viral RNA is produced by the infected cells. New viruses are produced, and these new viruses can infect the other cells. But the infected cells can survive while viruses are being replicated and restored. And some of the symptoms of the HIV, that is headache and difficulty concentrating, and skin rashes, fevers in the night hour, about digestive system, nausea, vomiting and diarrhea, nail thickening and curving, weight loss and the fatigue, joint pain, muscle pain, respiratory system, dry cough, pneumonia and a sore throat, and the lymph node and swelling. Next slide. As we know that the AIDS don't has any curing means, we have to take diagnosis and associated infections. In disease like this, early testing plays a very important role, as there is no cure. It allows for early treatment and reduce risk for transmission. Blood detection test used to detect HIV or ELISA, PCR and Western blot confirmation test. Urine Western blot can also be used as a testing method. HIV is associated with a number of associated bacterial, that is TB and viral herpes, influenza and fungal, Cryptococcus and the Candida infections, and they are also known as opportunistic infections. Medical follow-up, continuous testing and proper medication are key to reducing mortality due to HIV. Will continue.
Good afternoon. Am I audible to all?
Yes, audible as well as visible.
Yes, Viresh.
Now I am going to continue with the methods which are necessary to prevent the AIDS. Avoiding sex with multiple partners. This is one of the major problem in the society, as the prostitution is increasing nowadays. Avoiding unprotected sex and use of barriers like condoms. For men, Nirodh is a popular brand, and even in the society, there are many other brands like Manforce, Durex Air Ultra Thin Condoms. Refraining from intravenous drug use. Nowadays, the majority of the youths are being addicted to this drug use. Don't share used needles under any circumstances, maybe for drugs, tattoos, or body piercing. Avoid exposure to blood products. The even AIDS can spread through transfusion of a blood. So before transfusing the blood, one must go for a blood checkup. Next slide. The World AIDS Day. This was first introduced in the year of 1988, and this was introduced by John Mayer, an American journalist and an HIV educator, in order to create awareness among the people regarding the AIDS. The World AIDS Day aims on raising money, increasing awareness, and fighting prejudice with respect to remind people that AIDS has not gone yet, and there is still many things to be done. Unlike polio and other diseases have been eradicated from the society, the AIDS is still present in the society. So this must be eradicated from the society. Around half of the people get infected before 25 years of age and die before 35 years of age due to AIDS. So 25 to 35 years means majority of the people will come in this age only. So people must be aware from this age. Next slide. Previous slide. Once you play the previous slide, the main theme of the 2020 World AIDS Day was ending the HIV/AIDS epidemic, resilience and impact. This is going to focus on creating global solidarity and providing resilient services. Next slide. Statistical data on HIV in India. As per 2019 report, India reported 23.49 lakh people living with AIDS. The HIV infections in India have an overall decreasing trend with 37% decline between 2010 to 2019. Nationally, HIV infections accounted for about 3.2% of all deaths among people aged between 15 to 59 years in India. State-wise, Maharashtra was estimated to have the highest number of HIV cases in 2019, followed by Andhra Pradesh, and next our Karnataka. Next, continue with the further presentation. Thank you.
Okay, good information regarding AIDS by these two students. Actually, earlier programs would be conducted through government to create awareness and all. But you students, you are giving very good information and awareness for the benefit of all. Very good. Yes, now you can continue.
Good afternoon, everybody. I am Aishwarya, and now I am here to explain about drugs and substance abuse, and its causes. Why do people take drugs? So, what are drugs? Drugs are chemical substances of non-structure used to treat, cure, or prevent a disease. On the other hand, it is a substance which is administered in order to induce insensitivity. Some of the drugs are beneficial while others are harmful. These beneficial drugs played important role in this COVID-19 pandemic. India is also one of the country which is mostly affected by drugs and substance abuse. This study focused mostly on drugs addicts in the age group of 10 to 75 years. This says that youths are more vulnerable to these drugs.
Yes, one. Are you presenting the statistics also?
No, ma'am. About my teammates will present afterwards.
Oh, it is there, no? Okay.
My teammates.
Okay.
Tobacco and cannabis and other drugs are psychoactive substances where people get addicted to those substances, and these substances addiction causes serious impact on our physical and mental functions of our body. However, these drugs addiction causes main impacts on our body. There are six different categories of drugs. They are cannabis, hallucinogens, inhalants, narcotics, depressants, and stimulants. Hallucinogens, these group of drugs which causes hallucination, that is alter in feeling and thoughts and images that seems real, but they are not. Inhalants, these group of drugs are concentrated and inhaled via nose or mouth. Narcotics, these reveals pain person to get addicted to these drugs. Depressants, these drugs mainly slow down the rate of body functions. Example, alcohol. We can see people like drunkards can't walk steady on roads. Stimulants, these group of drugs make the person hyperactive or active in any field. Example, used by sportspersons to reduce tiredness and to gain energy. They are used. And another example we can give that caffeine present in coffee make person awake and less tired, feel less tired. Next slide.
You have not included dopamine?
I mean,
these sports persons, they will take this dopamine, no? Athletes. That in which category it will come?
I think in stimulants, ma'am.
Previous slide you take? Previous slide. You have to mention that also. Okay, dopamine is one drug that is consumed. No? Normally in blood test and all, dopamine levels will be observed. No, for sports person, if they are having that as positive, they will be suspended for so many years and all, and they will be having fine also. No, normally the dopamine has come in many consequences. Okay, you can continue.
Yes, ma'am. Causes of drug abuse. Next slide. Okay. As we all know, people all take food substances. But why do people not getting addicted to those foods? This is the reason behind it is because of some kind of pressures, which acts on brain, make them to addict to this drug substances. Once person takes these substances, they start enjoying life, maybe in an artificial elated mood. That is why they get addicted to it. If they don't take these substances regularly, they will get withdrawal symptoms, and this make him to take the substances frequently. The first common cause influencing drug abuse is parental influence.
When you are telling parents, you are starting directly parents anta. The parents anta helbedri. Grammatical error agutte. Okay.
I can't hear you, ma'am.
Okay, you can continue.
The common causes are parental influence, peer pressure, satisfying curiosity, revealing tension. Parental influence, which means the parents also are addicted to those drugs, and the children may get influenced that they will also use those drugs. Peer pressure, the friends with
children
them influence.
Yes.
Yes, ma'am.
Don't call us children. Okay, you have to call it as children.
Okay, ma'am.
Child is singular. Children is plural. Plural na matte plural maadbedi.
Okay, ma'am. Peer pressure. It can be more impacted on person. The peers with same group are forcefully pushed to take these substances. The students, they are addicted to the drugs mainly by this cause. Drugs are sold for students. The drugs are sold for free. As they once are addicted to that, they start buying them with money, and what we'll say. Drug peddlers. And another cause is satisfying curiosity. The thoughts of trying the substances for once make person to come over this decision, as they don't know the serious impact of it. To satisfy their curiosity, they'll start taking the drugs. How it will be and what the impact of that making this. The impact of drugs are not known by them. Revealing tension, mainly students, due to their poor academic performance or inability to connect with people, or due to overcome depression, loss of respect among their friends, to make him these make them to take the drugs. And there are some more causes of drug addictions, like they feel lonely to get interact with people. They didn't interact with people. Some of commonly used drugs are cocaine, alcohol, heroin, opioids, marijuana, and ketamines. These are all drugs which are used commonly and which affect the youth mostly. Thank you.
Very good presentation by you. Actually, These drug peddlers are more in Bangalore, and in many colleges, the students are addicted to drugs. Okay, so it is just a curiosity thing. Nothing is there. They will feel happy, they will feel hallucinated, and they will feel stimulated, which is not actually required. As you rightly told, in tea and coffee, caffeine is present. Okay. This caffeine, if you take 1 or 2 cups per day, it is a good beverage for you to daily just get stimulated lightly. But if you are having the habit of taking or drinking tea or coffee for some 6 times or 10 times, no, ultimately what happens is you will be stimulated throughout the day. And because of this stimulation, what happens? You will be going for urination frequently. That means it is a diuretic. Caffeine is a diuretic. It removes moisture from your body. So it is a diuretic. So which is not advised as nutritionist also. Simple tea and coffee, if it is used in excess amount, it is also having the adverse effects on the health of the body. And because of continuously taking, you don't feel like having food also, because there will be loss of appetite if your brain is stimulated all the time. Okay. And if you are working simply just by taking tea or coffee, you will not be feeling like having food also. So if you don't have food, what happens? Again, due to improper intake of food and all, you will have iron deficiency, anemia also. Okay. If you are just tea or coffee drinker, that is for 6 to 10 times. Okay. Similarly, all these whatever drugs she has mentioned, so they are also having very serious effects on the health, and it is happening. Okay, so in many colleges, students are simply addicted, and it is very difficult to revert back to the normal state. Maybe you have seen so many movies as examples, so that itself is more than enough for you to understand. How to get back is also difficult, and how to enter in that is very easy. Okay. Okay, good presentation. You can continue.
Good afternoon, friends. Myself, Anusha. Now I'm going to talk about the drug abuse. Drugs are the substances that change the way a person acts, feels, and behaves. When drugs are taken in the form of overdose, the term drug abuse is applicable. Generally, there are 4 stages in the drug addiction: stage 1 addiction, stage 2 regular use, stage 3 risky use and also called abuse, stage 4 dependency. Drugs are both legal and illegal. Many times, taking drugs becomes out of control. This ruins the complete life. People are affected financially and legally as well. They tend to ruin their relationship in life, whether they are personal or professional. The most common reason to take drug is to escape from the reality. Now let us see how drugs are taken. Some drugs are inhaled, some are orally consumed, some are through body orifices, some are taken intravenously, some are taken in the form of injections, for example, cocaine and morphine, some are snorted. Snorting is a common form of drug abuse in which people take a drug in powdered form and forcefully breathe it up into the nasal cavity. Next slide. Consequences of the drug addiction. Drugs are the chemicals. Different drugs can affect the body in different ways. This is due to their chemical structures. In fact, some drugs can even change a person's body and brain. There are so many side effects and health problems due to this drug addiction. They are loss of appetite, headache, anxiety, increased blood pressure, chest pain, irregular heartbeat, changes in the body temperature. Apart from this, it weakens the immune system, that increase susceptibility to the infections, abnormal cardiovascular conditions that ranging from the abnormal heart rate to the heart attacks, liver failure, cause the liver to have to work harder, possibly causing significant damage to the liver, also produce global body changes such as breast development in the men, dramatic fluctuations in appetite. There will be widespread brain damage. The drugs nicotine, cocaine, marijuana, and other drugs affect the brain's reward circuit, which is the part of the limbic system. Birth defects. These drugs may pose various risks for the pregnant woman and their babies. Some of these drugs can cause a baby to be born too small or too soon. Pregnant women who use illicit drugs may engage in other unhealthy behaviors that place their pregnancy at risk, such as having extremely poor nutrition or developing sexually transmitted infections. Behavioral problems. There are several behavioral problems due to this drug addiction. There are,
and even abortions will be there, no, in pregnant women?
Yes, ma'am.
Abortions will be there, and there will be difficulty in conception if a woman is taking drugs.
Yes, ma'am.
Problem, infertility problem will also be there. This, this is the same thing with respect to men also. Okay, there will be infertility problems.
Yes, ma'am. There will be breast development in the man. Behavioral problems. There are several behavioral problems due to this drug addiction. They are aggressiveness, hallucinations, impaired judgment, impulsiveness, loss of self-control, paranoia, and anxiety. Thank you, friends. Now I request my friend Akshata to continue.
Good afternoon, everyone. Myself, Akshata. My topic is on drug use in youth. Young people's brain are growing and developing until their mid-20s. This is especially true of the prefrontal cortex, which is used to make decisions. Taking drugs when young can interfere with developmental process occurring in the brain. It can also affect the decision-making. They may be more likely to do risky things, such as unsafe sex and dangerous driving. The earlier young people start using drugs, the greater the chances of continuing to use them and become addicted in later life. Next slide. Why do young people take drugs? There are many different reasons why young people may take drugs. So there are different reasons. Like, first reason is like to fit in. Young people may do drugs because they want to be accepted by friends or peers who are doing drugs. Then is to feel good. Abused drugs can produce feelings of pleasure. Then to feel better. Some young people can suffer from depression, anxiety, stress-related disorders, and feeling pain. And they may do drugs to try to get some relief. Then to get to do better in academics and sports. Some young people may take stimulants for studying and anabolic steroids to improve their athletic performance. Then to experiment. Young people often want to try new things and new experience, especially ones that they are thrilling and daring. Next slide. What are the signs that a young person has a drug problem? So here are some signs that one can make out that whether he or she is taking drugs or not. The first sign is that they change friends a lot, then spending a lot of time alone, then losing interest in favorite things, not taking care of themselves, for example, not taking showers, changing clothes or brushing their teeth regularly, then being really tired and sad, eating more or eating less than usual, being very energetic, talking fast or saying that things doesn't make sense, being in a bad mood, missing important appointments, having problems at school, like missing classes, getting bad grades, etc., having problems in personal and family relationship, lying and stealing, memory lapses, poor concentration and lack of concentration, slurred speech, etc. Next slide. Can drug use in young be prevented? Obviously, yes. Drug use and addiction are preventable. Preventable measures involving families, schools, communities, and media may prevent or reduce drug use and addiction. The first preventable measure is that motivational incentives to reinforce abstinence. The next, motivational interviewing to utilize the person's readiness to change behaviors. Rehabilitation to assist those with severe addiction or coexisting mental illness through the initial stages of quitting. Family therapy to help the family understand the problem and to avoid enabling drug use. Identification and treatment of coexisting conditions. Medications to decrease cravings, block withdrawal symptoms, counteract drug effects or to cause unpleasant side effects if a drug is used. There are many prevention which is done by the government, like World No Tobacco Day and World Drug Day. World No Tobacco Day is yearly celebration informs the public on the dangers of using tobacco. The business practices of tobacco companies, whose WHO say is doing to fight the tobacco epidemic, and what people are around the world can do to claim their right to health and healthy living and to protect future generation. The member states of the World Health Organization create World No Tobacco Day in 1987 to draw global attention to the tobacco epidemic and the preventable death and diseases it causes. In 1987, the World Health Assembly passed resolution calling for 7th April 1988 to be a World No Smoking Day. WHO called 31st May as World No Tobacco Day. The next preventive measure.
Why it is celebrated, ma? World No Tobacco Day, why it is celebrated?
To give information about the deaths caused and what are the effects caused, to create awareness,
to create campaigns, especially related to tobacco use. Tobacco is consumed through smoking as well as through chewing. And there are many drugs also that you have mentioned. No, it is mainly to create awareness. Every year there will be one theme. Okay.
Then World Drug Day. The International Drug Day Against Drug Abuse and Illicit Trafficking, also known as World Drug Day, is celebrated annually on 26 June. The theme of World Drug Day 2020 is Better Knowledge for Better Care. The field of addressing the drug problem has been plagued by misinformation of many kids. This year's theme aims at improving the understanding of world drug problem and at fostering greater international cooperation for countering its impact on health, governance, and security. Next slide. So let me give some statistical information about the drug abuse in India. Drug abuse increased 30% in India in last decade. About 75% in its youth are severely addicted to drugs. That is 3 out of every 4 children. In Puducherry, I reported the highest suicide rate at 36.8%. In India, 14.6% are addicted to alcohol and 12.6 lakh people are drug users, in which majority of them are youths. The survey estimated that the whose population is in billion, in that point, 8.75, 2 million use opiates and 0.6 million use sedatives or hypnotics. 17% to 26% of these people can be classified as dependent users who need urgent treatment. About 25% of users of opioids and cannabis are likely to seek treatment. The potential number of people seeking treatment, about 0.5 million opioid users and 2.3 million cannabis users and 10.5 million alcohol users, which is a serious challenge for India at present. So the total number of deaths caused is like 745 deaths due to drug overdose, which was recorded in 2017, and 875 deaths in 2018, and 704 deaths in 2019, which is increasing a lot. And over 2,300 people died due to drug overdose in 2017 to 19 in India, with the highest number of such fatalities recorded in the age group of 30 to 45 years. And the highest number of deaths was reported in Rajasthan at 338, followed by Karnataka at 239 and Uttar Pradesh at 236. The highest number of deaths
Karnataka data, which year?
Ma'am, latest years, ma'am.
238 means it is more in Karnataka.
It's next to Rajasthan. It's 338.
It is more only. That is it. I thought Punjab is higher.
Punjab is higher in drug abuses, not deaths.
No, deaths only. I thought Punjab will be having more deaths and because the drugs drug intake is more. Up, I thought like that. Okay, can continue.
The highest number of deaths from 2017 to 19 was recorded in the age group of 30 to 45 years at 784. The highest number of below the age of 14 years, as many as 55 children died due to drug overdose and 70 children died in the age group of 14 to 18 years, which are youth. A total number of 624 people died in the age bracket of 18 to 30 years and 550 people died in the age group of 45 to 60 years due to drug overdose. So by these two graphs, we can make out that the number of deaths from substance use disorder in the world is majorityly consists of youths. So let's be aware, guys, of drugs and be safe and say no to drugs. Thank you. Now my friend Amrita CS will continue with the further presentation.
Good afternoon to one and all. So my topic is Homelessness is defined as the delivery of specialized nursing care services in the home healthcare settings. It is a nursing specialty in which nurses provide multidimensional home care to patients of all ages. Home healthcare is a cost-efficient way to deliver quality care in convenience of the client's home. Home health nurses create care plans to achieve goals based on the client's diagnosis. These plans can include preventive, therapeutic, and rehabilitative actions, etc. Next slide. What are the general instructions for home nursing? While nursing the patient at home, one should remember first objective, provide nursing. Second objective, keep the patient and his room in nursing order. Third objective, remove all shortcomings of cleanliness. Fourth, essential to make family independent in taking care of their health, so their activities should be carefully monitored. Fifth, time to time, the nurses should consult the doctors on the status of the patient and provide feedback on any potential changes that need to be made to the care plan. Next. What are the characteristics of home nursing? The unique characteristics of home nursing is that it is a caring profession. Home care nurses function independently in a variety of unfamiliar home settings and situations. The nurse has to establish trust and rapport with the client and family. Home care is often given with the other family members present. Families may feel more free to question, advise, and to set their own priorities and schedules. Nurse should have nurse sense of humor, problem-solving skills, stamina, communication skills, commitment to patient advocacy. Thank you. Next, over to Arjun.
Arjun, can you please continue?
What happened? It is static.
Arjun.
Slide is static.
Mama, it's Arjun's turn.
Arjun is out of Zoom class.
Arjun?
Or he's sleeping?
Arjun?
Ma'am, I don't see him in the meeting.
Still, how many students have to present? This is the last.
Ma'am, two more.
You can continue with them. If he comes, no, he's the slides. You skip this slide.
Okay, ma'am.
Here, you mean to say youth is having role in nursing also. That's why you have prepared these slides, sir.
Bhavani, you can continue.
Bhavani is absent for today's class.
Hello, good afternoon, everyone. Is my voice visible, audible to all?
Yes,
ma'am. Audible and visible. You are visible also. You can switch on your video.
Yeah, ma'am. I switched on my video.
Good.
Thank you. Good afternoon, everyone. I'm here to present the topic, first aid. First, let us see what is the definition of the first aid. First aid is an emergency aid or a treatment given to someone injured suddenly ill and before regular medical services arrive and can be reached. And the Encyclopedia Britain states that first aid as the measure to be taken immediately after an accident, not with an idea to cure, but in order to prevent further harm being done. It uses the available human and material resources at the site of an accident to provide ensured care to the victim of injury or sudden illness until more advanced care is provided. Let's see the history of the first aid. First aid is invented by the Friedrich S. March in 1878. The father of the first aid is Dr. Matthew Schild. In 1817, Persian military surgeon Friedrich von Esmach introduced formalized first aid to the military and first coined the term Erste Hilfe, translating to the first aid, translated into the first aid, including training for soldiers in the Franco-Prussian War on the care for wounded commanders using pre-burnt bandaging and splitting skills. First aid kit is invented by the Johnson in 1888. Let's see the first World's First Aid Day when celebrated. World's First Aid Day is celebrated on September 12th. Is celebrated as in order to increase awareness and accessibility to the first.
Recording in progress.
And 2020, World First Aid Day is a first aid saves life. Let's see the objectives of a first aid. There are 3 points govern all the action undertaken by a first aid. First is a prevent further injury, worsening of the condition, preserve life, promote recovery. And the goals of the first aid is to restore and maintain vital function. The ABCs of the basic life support, airway, breathing, and circulation are always the first priority. Airway must be open so that air containing oxygen enter the body. Breathing must take place so that the oxygen passes through the lungs into the bloodstream. The heart must circulate the oxygen carrying blood. To prevent further injury or the deterioration, first aid has to be done. The action plan of the first aid. Action plan is a vital aid to the first aider is in assessing whether the victim has any life-threatening conditions and if any immediate first aid is necessary. There are DRABC. D means the check for danger. R means to check for response. A, check airway. B is check for breathing. And C is check for circulation. Next slide. let's see some of the statistical data of the first aid. According to the report in the Times of India, nearly 27% death occurred due to the want for medical attention. In another report in DIVX, nearly 50% of the road accidents death could have been prevented if primary care was given to the victim within hour of an injury. A timely provided first aid can be the difference between the life and death. So I request all to give a first aid if you found anyone who need a first aid in an accident cases. Next, see the golden rules of the first aid. Do first things first, quickly, quietly, and without any fuss or panic. Give artificial respiration if breathing has stopped as every second count. Stop any bleeding. Do not allow people to crowd around as fresh air is essential. Move the person as little as possible and handle gently. Do not attempt to do too much. Do the minimum required to save life and prevent the condition from worsening. Arrange for medical help as soon as possible. Next. Important of the first aid. Providing quick medical treatment until professional assistance arrives. First aid ensures that the right method of administrating medical assistance are provided. Knowledge is first aid also benefits the individuals themselves. If offered people with the ability to provide help during various emergency situations. Let's see the what should be in an every college student's first aid kit. It should have two dressing bandages, adhesive bandages of various sizes, elastic bandages, and a digital thermometer, cotton balls, disposable mask, rubbing alcohol, medical tapes and scissor, ice packs, disposable non-latex gloves, pulse oximeter, hand sanitizer, gauze pads and tweezers, hydrocortisone cream, hydrogen peroxide, antibiotic creams, etc. And we have various universal symbol for the first aid. Previous slide. The symbol mentioned in the upper corner, it's a universal symbol of the first aid. And there are many situations for which first aid can be done. For accident cases, snake bite, drowning, suffocation by poisonous gases, burns, electric shock, fainting or losing consciousness, bleeding, nose bleeding, fractures and sprains, poisoning, etc. I'll hand over now Anika for continuing the what are the first aid to for doing for different situation. Thank you.
I would like to talk about the basic first aids that one every student should know. The first being first aid for a wound. So if you end up cutting your hand and it is bleeding, what is that you should do first? If possible, raise the part of the body above the heart. Keep a clean piece of cloth and press it to prevent blood flow. Then thoroughly rinse with water. Use a hydrogen peroxide or any antiseptic, Dettol or Savlon also would do. Protect the wound using an antibiotic cream and cover with a sterile dressing. The next is in case of severe bleeding. If it is not a small cut, which will stop bleeding after a minute or two, in case of severe bleeding, here is what we should do. First of all, if you are treating someone else, make sure you have protected your hands and check if there is nothing inside the wound. Just take a clean piece of cloth or wound pad and cover it over the wound and let it be. Try to raise the injured limb and make sure the person lies down. Bandage firmly to control the bleeding and snot so that the blood doesn't come to them. seek medical attention if you are unable to seek the bleeding and casualty goes into shock. First aid for burns. I think burns is something that is very common to the common to all of us, and we would have burnt our hand sometime or the other. So what is that we need to do in case of a burn? First of all, we need to remove any kind of jewelry or clothing that is stuck around the skin in case of the burn. Then you have to cool your hand under running water for at least 10 to 15 minutes. Never apply anything like ice, heat pad, oil, butter or ointment at this point of time. Then lightly cover the area with a lint-free cloth or a wrap to protect the skin. In case of severe second degree or third degree burns, make sure you seek medical advice before doing anything. First aid for snake bites. I think snake bites are something which we will come across very common if we are in a farm or in a garden. In case a person has gone through a snake bite, make sure that the victim is sitting in a comfortable place and try to keep the victim calm, because it will help in reducing the blood flow. Ask the patient not to move the affected part and try to place it below the heart level. Apply pressure on either side 2 to 3 inches and to prevent the spread of venom. Immediately transport the person to a hospital as soon as possible, because in case of snake bites, there is no room for any error. If you do not get an antivenom in time, it could be a matter of life and death. So with this, we would like to conclude our presentation. I hope the awareness and information we provided was useful to you. We appreciate your patience and interest. Thank you so much. We would also like to thank our course teacher, NSS, Dr. Shamshed Begum, ma'am, for giving us this opportunity. Ma'am, it's appreciated. Thank you so much.
So very good efforts by the whole group.
Ma'am. ಅರ್ಜುನ್ ಕಂಟಿನ್ಯೂ ಮಾಡ್ಬೇಕಂತ
ಇಲ್ಲ ಅವಂದ ಆಯ್ತಲ್ಲ ಅಬ್ಸೆಂಟ್ ಇದ್ದ ಕ್ಲಾಸ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ
ಮ್ಯಾಮ್ ಇಟ್ ವಾಸ್ ಎ ನೆಟ್ವರ್ಕ್ ಇಶ್ಯೂ ಮ್ಯಾಮ್
ವಾಟ್ ಅರ್ಜುನ್ ನೌ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಎಂಟರ್ಡ್ ನೌ ದೇರ್ ಇಸ್ ನೋ ಇಶ್ಯೂ
ನೋ ಮ್ಯಾಮ್ ನೌ ಐ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಕೇಮ್ ಟು ಫಾರ್ಮ್ ಮ್ಯಾಮ್ ಯಾ ನೆಟ್ವರ್ಕ್ ಇಸ್ ಓಕೆ ಮ್ಯಾಮ್
ಓಕೆ ಓಕೆ ಎನಿ ಹೌ ಯುವರ್ ಸ್ಲೈಡ್ಸ್ ವರ್ ಸೆಲ್ಫ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ಲೇನೇಟರಿ Okay, I will mark, I will give you attendance, your slides were self-explanatory, okay, no problem.
Okay, ma'am, thank you.
Okay, okay, Anika, good efforts by the whole group.
Thank you, ma'am.
Who has prepared this PPT?
Ma'am, I prepared, ma'am.
You prepared, okay. So now tomorrow exam is there, you all know, no?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, Gavi Siddesh, are you there?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Okay, to my email ID, those who have presented presentations, those who have done, no? You submit your PPTs to my email ID, okay? drshamshaduas@gmail.com.
Yes, ma'am.
And remaining, maybe only for next week, they will be submitting that.
Yes,
so,
ma'am.
Tomorrow you all will be logging in Zoom only. It is just a half an hour paper, okay? Related to your presentations only, some four questions will be there. You are taking just half an hour.
Okay, ma'am.
30 minutes is more than enough to write that. Write important points.
Okay, ma'am. Okay, ma'am.
Okay. Okay, then I will end the session here.
Okay. Thank you, ma'am. Okay.